Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of Improving Your Work on VIP Art Digital Art Channel. My name is Cătălin and I'm a designer for fun. In today's video, we're gonna jump into Photoshop and I will show you how you can automate the entire optimization process for Redbubble baseball cap and that's hat, especially when it comes to landscape designs, photography, patterns, and so on. Basically, all over print design. So we're gonna have a quick look on how we can optimize all of this in Photoshop and also another three ways to improve those designs. So without wasting time, let's start working. Okay guys, welcome back to my computer. As you can see, we are already on my Redbubble store on one of my products. Why I came here is because I need a print size for our baseball cap and Stead's head. So we're gonna use this to create some templates. So first things first, let's head over to Photoshop. So we have here 2040 by 1140. So we're gonna go here, I'll just choose canvas size 2040 by 1140 and let's click OK. Proceed. And now we have the starting template. So this part we kind of have to remember. So let me open a sticker note. Okay, let me make it smaller a little bit. So here I'll write 2040 by 1140. Those dimensions are very important for us later on. Perfect. Now let's try to bring a design in. Right now we just need a reference. So I can bring anything inside. Let me find something. Yeah, probably this one. Let's drag and drop. So basically, if you have this kind of design on Redbubble, when you put it on a baseball cap, it will look something like this. Not so appealing. So let's try to play around with it, shall we? Let's see what else can we create. Let's see right now, I want to create a logo design using this graphic that takes 2/3 of this canvas, okay? So basically, what can we do? I can go here and I can choose the shape. For the stroke, I will let it 0 for now, the fill to black, and let's see what shape should we choose. We can choose a polygon, and here I can choose up to, let's see, 6 faces. Okay, let's drag and draw. So we're gonna create a hexagon. Okay, we're gonna hold shift to have a nice hexagon. Let's increase the size. Perfect. Let's choose the move tool, and let's try to center it. Here we're gonna, with the move tool selected, on the top where we have 3 dots, click on it, and make sure we select Canva and then center, center. Now, what I'm doing right now here, you can easily do it in Photopea. The steps are exactly the same. Now, this part, we're gonna hit Ctrl or Command T to enter the free transformation mode, hold Alt or Option, and let's scale this down a little bit. Let's say I want something like this, okay? Now here, if you want, you can play around. You can have this type, for example. Here, if I have my heart desire, I can hold Alt or Option while the move tool is selected, click and drag, and we can make another copy of it. Let's say I want to drag this one here, and I want to drag this one here, okay? And let's select all of 3Ds together by holding Shift. Again, with the move tool, click on these dots, and let's make sure that the distance is the same. Now, here we can play around a little bit more. So basically what I can do, I can click on this one, Control T, hold Shift, and let's rotate it 90 degrees. Okay, let's see, I can bring this one inside. Let's scale it down a little bit by holding Alt and Shift. Okay, so I can have something like this. Control T, let's bring this one in a little bit more. So for example, I can have it like this, okay? Double click, let's change color to red, Control T, and let's bring it down a little bit. I want something like this, okay? Now, the reason why I've done this is because I want to cut this shape that we have here. So now I can make a quick selection out of this by hitting Control or Command plus the thumbnail to make a quick selection. Go to the polygon, we're gonna select inverse and click on the mask. Now, if I hide this one, as you can see, we have created this cutout. That is really nice. As you saw, it's pretty fast. Now, this polygon, we can actually delete it. This one, we can actually delete it as well. I don't think I will use it. Right now, as you can see, I'm improvising. So with this one, we can hit Ctrl, Command, T, and let's try to rearrange it a little bit, okay? So I can place one here. I can hold Alt or Option, Shift, click, and drag, and I can have something like this. Okay, first of all, let's right click and convert to smart object each of them. Convert to smart object. Convert to smart object. Where is it? Okay, now let's hold shift, select them together, control command E, control command J to make a duplicate, control T to enter the free transformation mode, bring it this size by holding shift. Okay, here we can go to edit, transform, flip horizontally. Okay, and let's try to match the same position to have kind of like a symmetry. Okay, now here again, you can add more elements if your heart desire. You can choose the ellipse tool. Here I can add a circle here. Hold Alt or Option, choose the move tool, hold Alt or Option, shift, click and drag to add another one on the other side, and feel free to play around. And now as a quick tip, when you have a lot of shapes and you do not know which layer it is, or you have way too many layers, all you have to do is to have the move to select it and click on that shape, and the layer will get highlighted. Now we want to make a duplicate, so we click and drag to the plus. Okay. Now let's change the color for this one to red. So we double click here and let's change it to red. Control command T to enter the free transformation mode, hold Alt or Option and let's scale this down. Maybe something like this. Okay, it looks pretty cool. Now what we want to do, we want to lower the fill to zero. And we're gonna double click on the layer to bring in the layer style, and here we add a stroke. Now for the stroke, we can change the color, for example, to white or transparent, but let's change to white. Okay, and let's lower the stroke maybe to 10 pixels. Yeah, 10 pixels looks okay. So now what we want to do, we want to cut this stroke inside of our original polygon. So we're gonna convert this into a smart object. Convert to smart object. In this way, we preserve the transparency and the stroke. We're gonna hit Ctrl or Command and click on this thumbnail to make a quick selection of the stroke. We're gonna go to polygon one. We're gonna choose Select Inverse and we're gonna click Mask. Now, if I hide polygon one, as you can see, we have a lovely transparency applied. Now, let's say I want to keep this one. And if I want to have a quick preview of everything, what I can do, I can take all these shapes except this one, I can delete it. And all of the remaining shapes, we can select them together, Control Command E to merge them together. Now, if I bring our original design on the top and hold Alt or Option and clip it, this is what we're gonna get. And it looks pretty cool. Now, if you want to do this for every of your design manually, that's perfect. But you can take this design to a whole new level by applying some layer style. So we can double click here, we can add a drop shadow. In this way, it will give more like a 3D look. You can have a look of my settings. So I have blend mode normal. I have distance 14, 11, 1, and that's all. And then if you want, you can go to bevel and contour. And here, make sure the gloss, let's change this to linear. It will give a better look. The depth, we're gonna choose inner bevel. And now we have more like a 3D logo applied to it, and it looks pretty cool. Again, feel free to experiment which one works the best for you. Now, let's say we have finished this shape, okay? And we want to use this shape to automate all of our design. As you can see here, I do have quite a lot of designs, but to apply this shape for each of them, it is really time consuming. So instead, what we're gonna do? Well, first let's delete the effect because we don't need it. And let's hide this one because we don't need it. Let's hide the background. We only need this specific shape. Nothing more, nothing less. And let's make sure that it's centered to the artboard. And I will again choose the move tool. Go here, choose Canva, center, center. Now it's perfectly centered. So now what we want to do, we want to export the shape and the Canva. So we're going to go to File, Export PNG. And now let's save it on a desktop, for example. I will create a new folder and let's call this test one, create. Now keep in mind where you save those files is very important because next we're gonna create some actions. If you're moving the file from the folder you have just saved, your action won't work anymore. So you have to redo them again. So keep that in mind. Let's click create and I will save this one. Let's call this shape one. Okay, So now we have one shape created. Well, let's not move directly to the next step. Let's try something else, okay? Because as I mentioned, I want to show you three ways. This is the first way. Let's see the other two ways to improve your designs. So I can take this one and delete it. I can only have the background. Actually, I can delete the background, only our design, okay? Now, next what I want to do, I already went to Vexels and I download from there some silhouettes. Okay, let's see, I want to apply a silhouette to my design. So for example, I can take this mammoth, Control C. And again, if you don't have Vexels, do not worry, you can go to pixabay.com. So you can just come here and write Pixabay and just go to silhouettes. And as you can see, and from silhouettes, we're gonna choose vectors or illustrations. And voila, there are so many. So you can take one of these from here and apply it for your design. So I'll show you the same principle. Okay, I'll pass that one here. Let's Control C. Okay, paste it. Let's increase the size. This is a vector image, so it's very easy to play around with it. Okay, now, why have we done this? Well, if I bring my design on the top of it, Alt or Option and clip it, this is what we're gonna have. We can add more decorative elements. And the fastest way to do that is by going to the Shape Tools, and here we're gonna choose Custom Shapes, and let's go here and let's add more custom shapes. So I can go to Flowers, Wild Animals, go to the Legacies. Let's have a quick look here. I can choose conifer, I can choose this. Let's pick some of them that we like. Now let's select our background, Alt or Option to clip it, and this is what we have. Again, I can bring in the layer style to have a quick look. Voila, we have created another one. Now what I want to do, same as before, I want to export this as a shape. So we're gonna go to File, Export, quick export PNG. Let's call this one shape 2. Okay. Save. So we finished the second way. Let's see the third way. And the third way is my favorite approach. I already used it beforehand on my Redbubble store. So I will unclip and delete this one. And the third way is using sunglasses, binoculars, or reflective mirror. Let me give an example. What do I mean by that? So here I already prepared some sunglasses beforehand. So what I will do, I'll just drag and drop it here. Enter, and let's bring the other one. Drag and drop. Okay. Now this lens, I'll bring them behind O1 because the glasses, they have some reflection. Hold Shift, select them together, Control T, Alt or Option, and let's increase the size. I want to cover a huge amount of area. Perfect. Now let's have a quick look. So if I take my design, I don't want to bring it on the top of the glasses. No, I want to bring it between them. If I hold Alt or Option and clip, this is what we're gonna get. And here, as you can see on the sunglasses, we do have a small reflection on them, providing like a 3D look to them. And it looks pretty cool. So let's go here. Let me take those two and let's move them into test one file. So now here we have four shapes created for us. That's perfect. Okay, now let's start. So let's pick up a design. This is very important. Just pick any design from here. Doesn't really matter which one. We're gonna open it in Photoshop. And now that it's open in Photoshop, we have to do the followings. Under the Action tab, and if you don't see it, you're gonna go to Windows and choose Actions. Here, we're gonna create a new folder, and let's call this Test 1. Click OK, and then let's create Action 1. So we're gonna call this Shape 1, and then we're gonna click Record, okay? Now, first things first, we want to transform this image into a smart object. And here we're gonna go to Layers, Smart Object, Convert to Smart Object. Perfect. And here we are trying to avoid shortcuts as much as possible. So this means no mouse navigation on the layer tab, no keyboard shortcuts. Why? Because in this way, the entire process will work smoothly. Otherwise, they may cause some errors inside our action. So we don't want that. Now, the next thing that we want to do, we want to resize this image. So we're going to go to File, Automate, and we're going to choose Fit Image. And here we're going to type in our new dimension, 2040 by 1140. So 2040 by 1140. Click OK. So now this image got resized. Now, next we want to change the Canva area. So we're going to go to Image. We're going to choose Canva Size. And again, here we're going to write 2040 by 1140 and click OK. So this is what we're going to get. Okay. Now, it's not ideal, but this is the only way we can play around. So if we want, we can go to Edit, Transform, and here we're going to choose Scale. So let's scale this up a little bit, shall we? So right now, these ones are linked, so we can click and increase the size. Okay, all my images, they have the same resolution. So once I've done this, this is what I will get. I will click OK. With the Move tool selected, I can go here, I will choose Canva, and let's align it to the bottom, okay? Because this is my main goal, to have the bottom. I don't care about the top so much. Again, if you don't want this, you can easily center it in the middle. It will work well both ways. As you can see, all of the actions have been recorded. Now, once this is finished and we are satisfied with what we have here, we will go back to our document that we have just saved outside, test one, and let's bring in shape one, drag and drop. We're gonna click OK. And now we want to take this shape below layer one. So we're gonna click Control or Command on a Mac and the left bracket. This will bring the shape down. But now we want to go back to layer one. So we're gonna hit Alt or Option and the right bracket to go up. Now, once we are here, we want to clip it to shape one. So again, we cannot use keyboard shortcuts. So we need to go to layer. And here we have clipping mask, click on it. So now this has been applied to this, perfect. Now, what we can do, we can go back to layer one shape by holding Alt or Option and the right bracket to go down. And once we are here, we can double click. And here we can apply drop shadow, remember the values, and bevel, remember the values. Because we already used them before, they are saved in the memory, so we don't have to create them again. And that is really cool. So basically, that's it. We're gonna click OK. We're gonna go to File, Save As. Let's save it on the desktop somewhere, doesn't really matter where. And let's change the format. We don't want Photoshop, we want PNG. Okay, and the name doesn't matter. Let's click Save. Okay, and then we're gonna go to File, Close, and here, this is important, we do not want to save it. So we click Don't Save and Stop. As you can see, all of these things have been recorded here. This one I can remove it. And now let's record the second action. Okay, let's create a new action. Let's call this shape 2. And let's click record. We're gonna stop it for now because we need to bring the image back. So let's go back to the images. Let's bring in this one, for example. Let's go back to our folder. And now, same as before, click record. As you can see, the entire process is very easy. Layer, smart object, convert to smart object. File, Automate, Fit Image, 2040 by 1140, click OK. We're gonna go to Layer, we're gonna go to Image, and here we're gonna choose Canvas Size, and here we're gonna choose 2040 by 1140, click OK. This one, same as before, Edit, Transform, Scale, and we're gonna scale it up a little bit. Okay, again, I want to center it. Actually, it is also already centered, but I kind of want to play around to see which one looks the best. So let's see if I play like this. Nice. So all of this design, if I'm using this shape, will be pushed upwards. And that is really good. This is what I want. Now, as I mentioned, in order to have those templates work very well, make sure that the images that you've used are all the same aspect ratio. In this way, the entire process will work smoothly and the results will be perfect. Okay, now that we finish this, let's drag in the mammoth, drag and drop. Perfect, click OK, hold Ctrl or Command the left bracket to bring it down, Alt or Option, right bracket to go to this one, layer, we're gonna clip mask, Alt or Option, right bracket to go to the shape, and here double click, we're gonna click on bevel, drop shadow, OK, we finish with this one, file, save as, PNG, or JPEG, depends on which one do you want to choose. Desktop, save, OK, file, close, don't save. So we finish another one. As you can see, it's really fast. Once you have your shapes, the entire recording process of the actions is extremely fast. Okay, let's create a shape 3. Okay, record, stop recording. Let's bring in our designs. Okay, let's take this mountain area, for example. And this time it's more complicated because we have two shapes that we want to bring in. So let's see how to do this. Same as before, record, layer, convert to smart object, file, automate fill, sorry, file, automate fit image. Oh, we already have the setting, click OK. And then here we're gonna go to image canvas size 2040 by 1140. Okay, edit, transform, scale, something like this. And let's click OK. I like the position centered, so I don't think I'll make any modification to this one. Now let's bring in the design. So I want both of them to be here. Let's place one. Okay, let's bring in the second one. Okay, now as you can see, their size right now is pretty small. So the reason why I haven't exported as a PNG beforehand, same as I've done to the previous shapes, is because I want to teach you what can you do into this situation. So now we have these two shapes that yet are too small for our Canva, but we have two shapes. So how can we select both of them together without using the mouse? Well, we can hit Alt or Option and Shift, keep those two together, and the left bracket. In this way, we select both together. We're gonna go to Edit, Transform, Scale, and now let's scale them up. I will use my mouse on the top, and here we can scale them up. Something like this. And let's click OK. Now, right now we have to select it. Again, we cannot use the mouse, so we can use Alt or Option and the right bracket to go on the bottom. And again, Alt or Option and the right bracket, again, to go to the sunglasses. Now we want to take those frames, those glasses, and bring them underneath our image. We're gonna hit Ctrl or Command and the left bracket. And now those lenses are beneath our layer 1 design. That's perfect. And now what can we do? We can hold Alt or Option and the right bracket to go to our image. We're gonna go to layers, clipping mask, and voila, this is done. Perfect. Now, again, we can take this to a higher level. If we do not like, let me zoom in. If you do not like the way it looks, let's say those landscapes are too colorful, too bright. Well, we can play around with the blending mode. So here I can play around. I can choose multiply and check it out. It looks pretty cool. I don't like multiply. I can go for color burn for more colorful effects, or I can choose soft light, overlay. Again, feel free to play which one do you prefer. In my case, I think I'll go with multiply. I do like the effect. Okay. So, now we have this created. Next thing that I want to do, I want to apply drop shadow, but the frame itself, it's separated from our main lenses. So if I apply a drop shadow now, will affect the lenses as well, and I don't like that. So what can we do? Let's go to the frame by holding Alt or Option and the right bracket to go up. Now here I want to apply a bevel to the glasses. So let's double click on it and let's apply a bevel. As you can see, it applies bevel to kind of everything. Now here, you can let it like this and gives more 3D look, or you can let it original. I think I will apply the bevel just for fun. Let's click on it and let's change the setting to linear. Okay. Let's change to inner bevel. And I have more 3D look to them. It's perfect. Okay. And now what I want to do, I want to select all these three layers together. Why? Because we want to merge them into one. So we're going to hold Alt or Option, Shift and the left bracket to select all of them. Once they are all selected, we're going to go to layers. And here we can go to merge layers. Next, we're going to double click on it. And here we're going to click drop shadow. So this is optional, is mostly for decoration. So we can play around with the distance, with the size. So I can increase the size a little bit, spread, distance. So I can have something like this, for example. And then we're going to click OK. Now, once everything is finished, file, export, file, save us as a PNG. I want to save it on the desktop, save, OK, file, close, and don't save, and stop. Now, shall we give it a try? We have finished all these three actions. Now, let's try them out. So let's start with shape number three. Here, I want to go to this. I will right-click, create a new folder. Let's call this output. Okay. Right now, as you can see, output folder is empty. So next, what can we do? We have this shape 3 selected. We're going to go to File, Automate, Batch. And now, as you can see, Test 1 is selected, Shape 3 selected. Why? Because this is what we enabled beforehand. We're going to choose a folder that we want to transform. So let me find it very fast. And now let's choose Collection 1. And here I have quite a lot of designs. So I will choose this folder. And then here we want to make sure that Override Save As command is checked. And here we're going to choose the folder where we want to export everything. So I'll go to test one, output, choose. Now here, make sure you have the document name selected, first capital and the second one normal, and also add a digit serial number. Okay, the others, let them as they are, and let's click OK. Now once we click OK, the magic will happen. As you can see here, the files will start be generated one by one for all of our designs. So let's have a quick look. Okay guys, so it's finished. As you can see, we have done 51 designs in less than 2 minutes, and that is awesome. So let's have a quick look on them. Okay, so this is the first one, looks amazing. And again, check it out. Okay guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I also hope you're gonna give it a try, especially if you have Photoshop. Sadly, Photopea doesn't have the option to file automate everything, but the entire drawing and adding the shapes and the placement can be done easily just by a click of a button. So if you enjoyed the video, click the like button. It will help a lot with the algorithm, and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. So until tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye bye.